We're heading to the Walmart distribution center in Irvington, Alabama, but first, a ride through Mobile. Welcome to the joy of trucking. Let's go.
That's a beautiful skyline.
Destination. Different shade of green. Yeah. Oh, they look electronic or something?
Maybe they glow in the dark.
Maybe they glow in the dark, you're right. All right, well, onward.
intimidated by the sign that says dead end. You're going the right way.
Turnaround down here, too. After the entrance.
There is a turnaround?
Okay. After the entrance.
After the entrance. All right. Well, the first time we came here, our GPS sent us to the back of the DC.
Way behind it. We were looking at the back of the building, yeah. Going, how do we get in there?
And there were signs that said, hey, trucks, don't go this way.
We couldn't turn around. We couldn't back up. We had to take a country road that went way up the other side of the interstate.
And then through the town.
Yeah, about 10 miles, so we could come back here.
Yeah. In front of the building. And here's the big sign. But they don't have a sign further out like a lot of them do. You know, they'll point you in the right direction.
Loves or something, eh?
Yeah. Sign closer to that road would be good.
At the time on the satellite image, this building wasn't even here.
Well, when you were here with Werner.
Yeah, the first time, 2 years ago.
We have not checked the satellite image since then. Maybe they've updated it.
Yeah.
But this place is very large.
Yeah.
And now we know to come in the front, and so do you. So if your GPS is telling you to go any other way except past the Loves, you're not going to get to the entrance. So you turn by the Loves and head back here.
7 miles ahead. Turn right.
Continue 3/4 of a mile to the end of the street, then turn right.
Everybody stop talking.
Trailers is meant for us.
Do I see a green?
I saw one.
That's probably it.
At the end of the street, turn right.
Usually, well, a lot of these DCs, they got a big yellow metal thing, and it's magnetic, and they slap it on the front of the trailer, or it's got a carabiner, and they hook it on one of the airlines. So that's how they track the trailers in here, right?
1 mile ahead.
It's got like a transponder or something. But this guy, we go to the back, I open the door, he looks in, and then he's got like a little refrigerator magnet. It's flat, you know. He's got this barcode on it. He just slaps it on the back by the tail lights, and I says, you take that off when you leave? Yeah. He says, you just like scan it. That's their trailer control method.
That's a new development.
I don't imagine you could find the location of the trailer with that, though. What do you think? It's not big enough to have a transponder in it.
It could have a small transponder. Like Bluetooth or something? Sure. Interesting to know, though. If anybody knows, put in the comments.
Well, we'll have to ask somebody. C6, C5, C4, we're going to C3, and then we're going to traffic. We're on yard moves, and we got a new message. So much happening. Look at all the cameras they got there on that pole.
Turn right.
Keep an eye on you. No shenanigans here.
There's a spot. Somewhere down there. There's traffic over there, I think, at the end of the road here.
something in there.
About that lamp post tonight. You're correct. I've seen somebody else's hit. Better safe than sorry, right?
Yep.
Distance. 33,000 pounds. So we don't have to bring them forward very much. Safe and legal. It's a lot lighter than I thought it would be, you know.
Sometimes when they do construction, they put those at the construction site, and then Lowe's puts different permits and things in there, and you're getting your supplies from Lowe's. So I was wondering if our AC wasn't working quite right, because it seemed to not be doing as good of a job as yesterday, but it's 97 outside and feels like 107 with the humidity, so I guess we have a lot more heat to overcome, especially because we've been opening and closing the door quite a bit. But woo-wee! It's hot! Wow!
Can you see why we all stopped? pins or posts that stick down there in the corner, and one over there.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you get? That's a thing for lifting sea containers.
Oh yeah.
Way
yeah,
up in the
yeah,
air.
Yeah, stack. Yeah, yeah. Wow. That is big. Oh, here comes his
escort.
Yeah. Tires on his load too. Do those count?
They're big.
And you were saying his front steers are his steer tires are actually
look extra wide, like they'll take more weight or something. Okay, you coming?
Sure. Thanks for joining us when we picked up the next load, made sure it was safe and legal, and also Kevin managed to not hit that stationary object. So if you could like the video, please do give it a thumbs up. Be sure to put your comments and questions
below. Have you missed the turnoff to that Walmart DC before? Let us know. And be sure to subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and we'll see you in the next video. With love from Kevin and Tanya. Bye.